Macmillan Audio presents Demon in the Wood by Leigh Bardugo. Read by Ben Barnes, Tom Bromhead, James Fouhey, Sean Gormley, Matt Leisy, Mary McCartney, Cassandra Morris, Eason Rytter, Salli Saffioti, and Benjamin Valic.
Witches in the woods. Don't laugh, child. They hide between the trees, in villages and towns. One may be listening to us right now. Tide makers, who control the seas. Squallers, the winds. And Inferni, who shape fire. Heartrenders, who can crush the lungs in your chest. North, in the cold wilds of Fjerda. South, in the forests and fields of Ravka, and here in the borderlands. These creatures move through our world, twisting it as they like. They are cursed, and they curse everything and everyone in their path. We call them witches, but they call themselves Grisha.
Do you think there are any Grisha around here?
Could be.
Stop frightening them. No Grisha to fear in these mountains.
There aren't?
They wouldn't dare. They're too scared of the witch hunters, the Druskala.
I want to be a witch hunter.
In the borderlands south of Fjerda, a boy stood at the edge of the forest, looking down at the quiet village below. The village he and his mother had carefully avoided. Now they would continue north into the snow-covered mountains.
Something wrong?
That's in Okazatia village, isn't it? You said we would reach the Grisha camp tomorrow.
If the weather holds.
Is it safe for the camp to be so close to that village?
Once the deep snows come, no one will venture into these mountain passes, not even to hunt. The camp will be secure.
She urged her mount up the slope, and he followed on foot.
Now, what's your name?
Eric.
Where are you from?
Palakirov.
And what's my name?
Madraya.
Wretched boy. Let's hope the Ula doesn't try to call me mother. Tell me my name.
Lena. For now.
For now.
Do we have to change our names every time?
You know we do. The world isn't safe for Grisha, and it's particularly dangerous for the two of us. You don't get to be a child like the others.
What if they ask me about my father?
You tell them he's dead.
Is he?
He will be, in the blink of an eye. You'll outlive him by 100 years. Maybe 1,000. Maybe more. He's only dust to you.
They went on like that as they made their way up the mountain. It was a foothill, really. One of the cold and silent peaks that marked the very beginnings of the Elgin Range.
Again, what's your name?
Eric.
Where are you from?
Alakirev.
As night fell, they wedged their tent inside an old hunter's blind. Lantern light spilled out across the snow. Eric watched from inside the shelter as his mother fetched a bundle of furs from her saddle and passed it to him.
You'll stay here tonight.
What about you?
I'm going to scout ahead. You know that Grisha are always cautious of outsiders. Here, look.
His mother set their lantern down on a tattered map of Fjerda. The village they had seen was marked on it, as well as the mountains. She traced a winding path through them with her finger.
This is where we are now. The camp is a few hours farther on.
She passed him a small loaf of bread from under her cloak.
Rye bread, a water skin, They should last you one night. I'll have to take the lantern.
But I...
He knew he couldn't ask her to leave it. He was too old to be afraid of the dark. Still, as she left the shelter, he couldn't help but follow the warm light.
It's our only one.
I know. I'll need it to light the way. You'll be all right, won't you?
You're too old to be afraid of the dark.
I'll be fine.
I should be back by midday.
He watched her ride away up the hillside. It had begun to snow. When the lantern's light vanished among the trees, he was left alone in darkness. That night he huddled in the firs and nibbled on the rye bread she'd left him.
You're too old to be afraid of the dark.
He curled up tightly beneath the firs. He knew he would never be able to sleep, but still he covered his ears with his hands.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.